Hi everyone. Oh my gosh, what a morning. My internet went out, and so I've been working the last 15 minutes trying to get it to come back up. It did come back up, and then I couldn't get Facebook to work, so I had to close my phone, reopen it. So anyway, now we're live. I apologize for the delay. The internet is something that I can't control, and I guess I controlled it because we restarted it, but it just went off at the wrong time. So anyway, thank you for joining Stretch Class. I'm going to get going since we're running late. Make sure you have your strap, and we're going to get going. I need this relaxing stretch now, so let's... Rosemary, thank you. I just don't like starting when things are like that. And I'm up here early getting things ready, but I didn't realize we didn't have internet. Press out that heel. Lean back. Leaning back. Grab below, like above your knee. Sorry, not below your knee. Above your knee. Pull. Behind you, feel the stretch.
hips. Your hands are below your shoulders. We're gonna have a nice flat back. Looking, having a straight back, even your head. Don't drop your head, don't raise your head. Nice and flat. Hopefully you have mirrors around you so you can check. We're gonna round our back. Drop your head, bottom's under, your back is round. And now tailbone's up, and your head is up. And hold that arched back. Out. Your right arm is up, so it's opposite. Nice flat back. And drop it down. Other side, right leg out, press out with your heel, left hand out. Bottom to our heels. I believe this is called child's pose. But maybe not. Walk your arms forward, drop your head down. Should hurt. joints should not hurt. You're going to feel the muscles stretching, but no joint should hurt. If it does, text me. I'll try to reposition you next time. I wish I could see you. Hold. Keep breathing. Breathing's really important. You want the oxygen going to the muscles. Never hold your breath. Even when we're exercising hard, keep breathing. All right, come back up. Sit up tall. I want you to take your band. I want you to put it underneath one foot and take it to the side. So now your legs are open. You're going to turn toward that foot. It in and hold. Are you feeling the stretch in your inner thigh? And go down a little bit further. Bring it in. Have your upper body come down. You're going to feel the stretch in your side as well, along the back of your leg. I want you to keep your belt or your rope in your hand, your stretching bar or stretching rope in your hand, and then take your inner arm and reach it over. Look at the ceiling. Increase that stretch. Just hold. Keep breathing. And wherever you are, reach just a little bit more. And come up. Wherever your foot is, can you make it go a little wider? I can't. But you probably can. Bring it up. Feel the stretch right here. Sit up tall. Out, turn toward that foot and pull yourself in. Hold. And go a little bit further. Hold. Shouldn't hurt your hips, your knees, your hip right here. Shouldn't hurt. Chest facing your knee. Hold. Take your inner hand, arm, bring it up. Look at the ceiling. Keep breathing. Reach a little bit forward. Shoulders back. I want you to take your right arm. I want you to bring it across and hold. You're holding above your elbow and bringing it in. So why is flexibility important? As you're holding this, I'm going to demonstrate. There's a book out there called, and we've talked about it before, but Younger Next Year. And he keeps stretching. He talks about how as you get older, your box of where you can reach and what you can do in your movement gets smaller for a lot of people. And so now you can't stand up as straight. You can't reach as far. And we want to keep that box as big as we can. All right? It'll help us in our everyday life. Okay, now take your other arm and bring it across. flexibility and stretching will help with that. So don't worry if you can't really get that arm bar across and you can only go here. You listen to your range of motion, okay? This is your workout, not mine. This is your stretching workout. And then hopefully, if you do this regularly, small baby steps, by the end of 222, maybe you'll get it a little bit further and you'll be a little more flexible. Sometimes we have limitations that our body just won't let us. Maybe an accident or a fall did something to a joint. You don't want to tickle there, stretch it out. You don't want to press it. So remember, you push as far as you can go, but don't torque it, okay? Arms are out and back. Bring your feet together. I want the band to go both legs, both feet. Lean forward. I am not flexible. Even when I was young and I danced, all my contemporaries were like, just on the knees, and they could reach past their feet. I couldn't do that. But I don't force myself. I just work at it. And the more I do this, the better I get, the further down I get. So just hold it. Hold it gently. You can feel it behind your leg. Breathe. Take a 15 breath in. And go forward just a little bit more. You're going to find, feel it behind your legs. All right, pull it in just a little bit more. Good job. All right, sit with your feet together. Pull those feet in. If you cannot get the soles of your feet together, sit however it's comfortable for you, all right? But if you can have the soles of your feet together, even if they're out here, this is good. You can just press open this way, all right? Do it where it's comfortable for you. I don't want any knees to hurt. Get it in. Take your arms. Press down. If your legs are further out here, press with your hands. Open it up. And just breathe. Try to relax. Try to relax into these stretches. Open it up a little bit more. Bring it just in a little bit more if you can, wherever you're at, and press those knees open. Drop your shoulders down. Pretend there's a string on the top of your head pulling you straight up. Shoulders are back and down. I don't think I was doing that. But I am now. So many things to think of, right? Cross your legs. Sit comfortable. If you're comfortable with your soles and your feet together, you can keep there. I want you to drop your shoulders down. And I want you to turn your head all the way to the left. Feeling the stretch of the right ear. Looking left, the right side of your neck. Shoulders are down and back again. Back to the center. Abs are in. Strong core. Straight up. Turn your head now to the side, to the right side. Shoulders are down. And hold. back to the center. Take your right ear, put it to your right shoulder. Do not lift your shoulder up. Just go down to the right as far as you can to meet your shoulder, which is down. Feeling the stretch on the left side of your neck. Keep breathing. These stretches seem small, but they'll help. I try to do something a little different each week. And come back to the center. Left ear to the left shoulder. Pressing your right shoulder down. Left shoulder down too. And just hold. Feel the stretch. Breathe. Drop your chin towards your chest. Sitting up tall now. Your spine is straight. Shoulders are down and back. If you want, you don't have to. You can press your head slightly forward, increasing that stretch. And come back up. And now keep your mouth open. Look back up toward the ceiling. Mouth open. Shoulders back, sitting up tall. Head back as far as it'll go. And now close your mouth. I have a hard time closing my mouth. It just moves and moves. Stand up. I want you to take your right hand. I want you to put it, grab your belt. Put your hand behind your back, or the rope behind your back. Elbow is straight up and you're pulling down. So you'll feel that stretch. Triceps, upper arm, you're feeling that stretch and just hold. Close your eyes, feel the stretch. Try to relax that muscle, those muscles. And now pull it down just a little bit more, keeping the elbow straight up. Don't go to the side, straight up, pulling down. Have you try to hold your fingers, that's harder to do. So remember, you can always use your stretch rope or belt or whatever you're using, towel. Alright, let's do the other side. Grab the rope. It's up. Stretch right here. Elbows up. So I've been talking online about the Daily J. It's on the Calm app. It talks a lot of very practical things you do. He used to be a monk. Pulling down, feel the stretch. All right, hold the rope, take it behind you. Holding it taut, and just feel the stretch. Today he talked about, you know, we get into these routines, the same old thing. But you can make it the same old, same new. Take your routine and observe what's around you, and it'll be different, and you can really be in the present moment. So if you're going for a walk, look for something new that you haven't seen before, a new flower. Of course, we're in Michigan, there are no flowers right now, but a new snow pile. Just stop and say, I'm going to a new rock. Maybe somebody painted their house. But observe new things as you're going for your ordinary walk that you normally do. If you're lucky enough to be in the woods, look for the barks on the tree and how they look and how they're formed. All right, feet are apart, knees are slightly bent. Take that rope, go to the side. And come back up. And now go to the other side. Feel that stretch. Pulling down on the rope. Up. Okay, you can drop that. You take your arms, you reach them out as far as you can.
If I ask you to dance,
push it back.
Would you run and never look back?
And now take your arms, cross them over.
If you saw me cry,
walk those hands.
Keep your
eyes closed.
My soul,
feel the hug that you're giving yourself.
Would you tremble? If I touched your lips, would you laugh? Oh, please tell me this. Now would you die?
Take your arms for the one back as far as you can again. Whatever arm was on the top last time, put the other one on the top. Walk those fingers closer together. Close your eyes. Feel the hug, feel the stretch across your back and your arms.
I will stand by you forever.
Think of something you're grateful for.
You can take
and really feel being grateful.
Would you swear that you'll always be mine? Would you lie? Would you
back out? How am I and now circle your arms. Slow. Full range of motion, whatever the full range of motion is for you. Stretch as far as you can forward. As far as you can up. Take it to the backs and the side. I can't get it straight back. And then back down. Let's do it again. Forward. Reach it. Up high. Opening up your palms, shoulder blades together, just hold that right here, and drop it down. Take both hands forward, lift it up behind your head, feel the stretch. Hands behind your back, reach it forward, squeeze those shoulder blades together.
I just wanna hold
you. If you can't grab your hands for whatever reason, just push back. Hold.
I love my mind. I don't care if you're here tonight.
Drop your hands down. Let's just twist your hand, arms straight up. Do a turn. Other side. Turn that wrist around, the hand around. Go the other way. Alright. Press up your palm. Go to the inside. Go to the outside. As far as you can. Shoulders and press it down. Hold it, standing up tall, abs in. Engage that core. And now bring it in. Tense it all up. And now down, chest out. Good, breathe it in, and exhale. One more time, breathe it in, hold it, hold it, hold it, and now exhale. Have a wonderful day. I will see you tomorrow, hopefully. We are having a regular step class. Even if you haven't taken step before or don't have a step, you can still join us. We're going to move around, get that heart rate up for 45 minutes. I so appreciate you. Thank you for joining. If you enjoyed the class, please share with a friend and comment. It really helps me stay motivated. I appreciate it. Thank you. See you tomorrow.